Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear students, we discuss some Sharia rules and principles regarding validity of ijara contract. There are more principles which we are going to discuss now. First thing is that the contracted usufruct has to be ascertained to avoid any dispute. Maqsad ke jab bhi koi lease agreement kiya ja raha ho, to ye bada wazeh ho ke kya fawaid iske natije mein kiraydar ko hasil honge. Misal ke taur par, agar makan kiray par diya ja raha hai, to usme kaun kaun se kamre kiraydar ke istemal mein honge, wo wazeh hai. Agar malik kuch hissa apne paas rakhna chahta hai, to is tarah ki cheezein wazahat ke saath contract mein bayan karni chahiye taaki baad mein koi ikhtilaf na ho. Isi tarah se ye bhi mumkin zaruri hai ke jo cheez kiraye par di ja rahi hai usse fayda uthana kiraydar ke liye mumkin ho. Misal ke taur par ek shakhs ek makan ka malik hai aur wo us makan ke kiraye ka muahida kisi fard ke saath karta hai, lekin wo makan kisi aur ne ghasbana qabze mein kiya hua ho, to kiraydar ke liye ye mumkin nahi ho sakega ke wo makan mein dakhil ho aur usme rihayish ikhtiyar kare. To aisi noiyat mein ye kiraydari ka muahida durust nahi hoga aur wo usi surat mein durust ho sakta hai ke jab asset kiraydar ko is tarah se available kar diya jaye ke wo usse benefit kar sake. Ek aur cheez isme ke asset ko uske liye handover karna ye ek lazmi taqaza hai contract ki validity ke liye. Jab tak asset uske handover na kiya jaye us waqt tak kiraya charge karna ye durust nahi hota, aur jab asset usko for useful benefit available kar diya jaye aur uske ikhtiyar mein de diya jaye, only then it becomes permissible that owner can charge rent from the lessee. Isi tarah se ek aur usool ye hai ke usufruct jo hai asset ka wo lawful hona chahiye aur jo objective hai contract ka wo bhi lawful hona chahiye. Misal ke taur par agar koi machine kiraye par di ja rahi hai aur us machine se koi impermissible aur illegal cheez produce karna maqsad ho, to ye lease agreement durust nahi hoga, aur jab bhi malik ko pata ho ke wo is cheez ka galat istemal hone ja raha hai to use is tarah ke agreement se istinab karna chahiye. Ek aur baat ahem ye hai ke the usufruct should be conventional or according to the tradition of the pupil, yani wo cheez society ke norms ke sath match karti ho. Koi aisa istemal jisse ke irgird logon ko nagawariyat ho aur wo unko ajnabi lage, to is tarah ka istemal karne dena kisi asset ka ye bhi durust baat nahi hogi. Aage jab bhi lease agreement ki baat ho to determination of rent isme ek ahmiyat rakhta hai. To iska bunyadi usool ye hai ke rent should be fixed and predetermined at the time of entering into contract, and this determination should be free of any doubt and dispute. Ke jitne arse ke liye bhi muahida kiya ja raha ho uske liye dono fareeqon ko, dono parties ko ye wazeh taur par pata ho ke kitna rent liya jayega. Aur agar long term contract hai, kai saalon par muhit hai muahida, to us surat mein agar to lease rent jo hai lease ka wo change kiya jana hai, tabdeel hona hai, to koi formula us tabdili ka wo bhi aapas mein pehle se waze kar lena chahiye. Misal ke taur par agar koi makan ek saal ke liye kiraye par diya ja raha ho aur usme ye tay ho ki is makan ka kiraya masalan 20,000 rupaye hoga, to isme koi mushkil pesh nahi aayegi. Lekin agar makan ke kiraydari ka muahida 5 saal ke arse ke liye kiya ja raha ho and it is known that rent will not remain the same during this 5 years period Why? Because prices are increasing, there is inflation in the economy, और उसकी वजह से मालिक भी किराए को तब्दील करना चाहेगा. तो ये तय हो सकता है कि मसलन हम 5 साल का मुहायदा कर रहे हैं एंड एवरी ईयर रेंट विल इंक्रीज बाई 1000 या रेंट विल इंक्रीज बाई 5%. तो इस तरह का कोई फार्मूला पहले से तय हो ताकि दोनों पार्टियों को ये मालूम हो कि मुख्तलिफ सालों में किराया कितना होगा एंड दे शुड एंटर इन टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विद कॉन्सेंट एंड एग्रीमेंट एंड दे शुड नॉट हैव एनी डिस्प्यूट इन द फ्यूचर अबाउट एनी क्लॉज ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट.